Hello everyone, thank you for clicking on this channel. This video is regarding narcissists will use your words against you. I will try my best to explain their negative patterns of behavior and how you can protect yourself. I would like to give a shout out to the cat lady who is a faithful viewer and always commenting with really good sound advice. Cat lady, I read your comments, I see your dedication, your wisdom, and most of all, your strength. If this is your first time visiting this channel, please subscribe to hear more interesting topics. Okay, here we go. Let's learn, reflect, relate, and heal. Over the years, dealing with toxic and negative people, I've learned their tactics and they thrive on negativity. If you tell them something negative, they store it into their memory bank, and then in return, they will periodically or continuously remind you of it, especially if it was something very negative, such as you sharing your fears, weaknesses, failures, vulnerabilities, or situations where you encountered a bad or negative experience. If you revisit that negative topic by bringing it up, pay close attention to their silence, because their silence is their way of absorbing what you said, so it can be used again in the future to tear you down. If by chance you shared personal things such as a bad divorce, growing up in a dysfunctional home, being abused or neglected as a child, your insecurities about your body or past relationships, or maybe even your medical history, or expressing your concerns about someone you don't really care for, etc., you will hear about it again. It will be repeated or replayed back to you as an unfriendly reminder, especially during the times you don't want to be reminded about it. If you share it verbally or on social media, or if they witness it with their own two eyes, prepare yourself to be tortured with a reminder of the negative circumstance. They will try to hurt you with your own words, and you responding or reacting gives them a sick, twisted pleasure. They enjoy preying on your insecurities by making you feel small, confused, or unloved. This is only done because this is the true reflection of how they feel about themselves. They tend to get this look in their eyes or tone in their voice, or their body language shifts or changes. It's like a switch that goes off that activates their negative memory bank. If you watch closely, they get very excited to replay the negative information back to you. Also, if you pay close attention to their cues, you will then see that they can tell you the story or situation better than what you can, even if it were weeks, months, or years have gone by. They will have the details and description perfectly laid out for you. They will bring it up abruptly during a phone call, dinner, during a meeting, a conversation about another topic, around your children or friends, or when you're relaxing or doing something that you like. Typically, this is done either when you're having a good day, you're in a great mood, or in a good space. On the other hand, when you had a bad day or were at odds with the toxic person or narcissist is when they will also ambush you with your own words. Sometimes they will twist the story or facts depending on the tactic of manipulation that they're using. Their malicious method is that they wait until the opportune time to bring it up with the intent to rattle you, to bring you down and cause emotional pain. In return, this makes them feel good. Their agenda is they want you to be weakened or in a weakened position because this creates power and control for them, which is narcissistic supply. The other thing that I have learned is that if you shared an experience such as you had a great day, a nice vacation, you're in great health, you came from a loving family, your ex was good to you and treated you with respect, you make a decent salary, you have good friends, etc., you won't hear them remind you of anything regarding those circumstances or experiences. The reason why you won't hear them remind you about any positive experiences you have shared with them is because it's positive. Their genetic makeup is not made to respond to anything positive. So you will hear dead silence or no response at all whenever you're sharing anything positive. Don't give them ammunition. Anything you share with toxic people will eventually be used to humiliate, hurt, or manipulate you, particularly when you are most vulnerable. Please be very mindful about what you reveal. Better yet, anything personal should not be shared with a toxic individual. A narcissist will sit and listen very carefully to all of your stories you tell them about yourself, the good, the bad, and the ugly. But they're not listening because they care to understand. They're listening to get information as ammo to be used against you at a later time to ambush you. Take note, they thrive on negativity. It is what feeds into their dark, empty souls. Research indicates someone who enjoys another person's humiliation, hurt, or pain is considered sadistic. Gorgeous one, guard yourself and your heart above everything, and love yourself so that nobody's words of manipulation can disturb your inner peace. If someone or a narcissist used your words against you, share your experience below in the comment section. I hope that this video was helpful and provided the insight that you are looking for.